Welcome to LoadRunner Tutorial 12. In this video, we will dive deeper into the analysis component of LoadRunner. I have the controller component open and I have open scenario 1. The difference from last time is that I have set up the duration as 10 minutes. We should run our performance test for at least 10 or 15 minutes in order to get a good amount of test results. Now, I have already set up the SLA in controller. In fact, it is better to set up the SLAs in controller so that LoadRunner knows in advance what our goals for the performance measurements are. So the first SLA is for the transaction response time. So I select this and I'm going to click on edit to show you the details. So this opens the SLA wizard. Click on next. So the measurement is for the transaction response time average. Instead of selecting the action transaction as last time, I've selected three different transactions: home page, book flight, and check itinerary. I've not given any load criteria because I want the same threshold for each transaction for any number of users. Now here I have given the threshold as 0.5 seconds. So each of these transactions has to complete within 0.5 seconds. Now the other SLA is for the average throughput as per our performance requirement examples. Click on edit, it shows the wizard average throughput in bytes per second. So this is 20,000 bytes per second. The threshold is at least 20,000 bytes per second. Now since this scenario is for 10 minutes, I've already run it. Now last time we opened the analysis component of LoadRunner by going to results and analyze results, but we can open it separately also. I already have analysis open and all we need to do is point it to the latest test results that we want to analyze. So click on file, new, to create a new session in analysis. And go to the folder results scenario 1 result 2. So this is going to open the test results in analysis. By default it opens the summary report, and the summary report has a number of sections after analysis summary. The first section is the statistics summary. Now here we can see the summary information: maximum running V users, 15 V users. It also shows throughput, average throughput, and so on. And if we click on a link, it takes us to the corresponding graph. Now the next section is the 5 worst transactions. It shows up to 5 worst performing transactions. Now we had 3 transactions: home page, book flight, and check itinerary. So in check itinerary, it reports that this transaction has failed 14.9% of the times. Book flight has failed 29.9% of the times. The next section is the scenario behavior over time. So here we can see that home page, the SLA status is pass. For book flight, the SLA status is fail. And for check itinerary, the SLA status is also fail. Then we have the transaction summary section within the summary report. And here it shows the SLA status. So home page is pass, book flight is failed, and check itinerary is failed. There is an HTTP responses summary also. And if we click on the link here, it shows us the HTTP responses per second graph. Now I'm going to click on the average transaction response time graph, and here we can see that this is for the action transaction, the complete transaction. So I'm going to select book flight here, so it highlights this particular line within the graph. Now if we place our mouse pointer, a yellow box appears which displays the details of that particular data point. Now in analysis, we can merge graphs into one. For example, if we want to combine running V users and average transaction response time, we can merge these two graphs. So how we merge is, right click on the graph and click on merge graphs and select graph to merge with running V users and click on correlate and click on OK. Go to running V users, right click, merge graphs and correlate with average transaction response time, select the correlate option and click on OK. So this basically merges these two graphs. On the x-axis we have number of V users, so we can see the number of V users from 0, 1 to 15, and on the y-axis we have the average transaction response time. Now here it shows all the transactions, but we can filter it. So let us say we are interested only in looking at the data of book flight, so we can right click, set filter group by, and here we can give the transaction name. We can give here as book flight and click on OK. So this shows number of E users and average response time of the book flight. This is how we merge graphs with the correlate option. Now I'm going to remove it. Now we can also use autocorrelate option to dive deeper into the book flight transaction, because as per the summary report, the SLA for book flight is failed because there are a lot of red boxes. So here first let me set the filter, right click, set filter, transaction name is equal to, and I want to just select book flight because that is the transaction I'm interested in. And here if you right click, you can click on autocorrelate, and this shows the entire range. And be careful to select a good range so that we have sufficient data for the correlation and the correlation is reliable. So we can drag the starting point, and here I want to drag the end point also so that we have running it for 15 V users. So click on OK. Now here it shows the data for the book flight, and here we have a correlation match. We can sort it in descending order, and here we can see that it has direct correlation, not much, but direct correlation with non-page bytes and cache bytes, etc. So basically it is a straight curve, but if we want to increase the performance, we can increase the memory on the server, and if we increase the memory on the server, this should lead to better performance of the book flight transaction, and our SLA would pass if the memory is sufficiently available. So that is about analysis, and we can create reports also from within analysis. We can create HTML reports, or we can create reports in Microsoft Word. In order to create an HTML report, click on report and click on HTML report. It asks where we want to save the report, so I'm going to just point it to the folder reports scenario 1. S115VU, and it generates the HTML report. So basically it is a summary report with links. It opens in the browser, and here we can see the summary. So the duration was 10 minutes and 15 seconds, 15 V users, total throughput, average throughput, and so on. And if we click on any of these links, it takes us to the graph. This is how we create the HTML report in analysis. We can also create the report in Microsoft Word. So click on report, new report, and there are a number of templates available. If we want a high level report, we can select that template, high level report for single run, and click on the generate button. So this will open up the report. So it says the scenario name, run name, run date, run duration, and we can see the business process details. We can see the running V users versus total transactions per second. We can see the performance overview and so on. And if we want a detailed report, that is also available from analysis. Click on reports, new report, and select the template as detailed report for single run. So the difference between high level report and detailed report is that the detailed report also shows the worst performing URLs, most resource consuming URLs, basically a lot of detail, and it also shows all the graphs that we have generated within our analysis session. So that is all for this video. Hope that now you have a good knowledge of HP LoadRunner version 12. And thank you for watching this video.